dear friends. Happy November. I hope you're all doing well. I actually can't believe that we're almost through 2022. I was looking through some questions that people sent me this past year, and I thought it might be helpful to answer some of the questions that I received on this podcast. There were some really good ones that I think that all of you can relate to. And the questions I chose are all about navigating our relationships with ourselves and the other people in our world. So let's just dive on in. I love this first question as it was really sort of all encompassing. It says, Leanne, I'm struggling with moving forward right now. I can't seem to make any decisions as everything feels so uncertain. Any suggestions? Love it. Direct and to the point. So I was thinking about this earlier, and I believe there are two things that we can be very certain about. One, how we will show up for the people we love. And secondly, how we will choose to think about things. No one knows right now what the future is going to bring, right? The rules of life seem to be changing on a daily basis. But the one thing we can be certain of is that we will always have the ability and the power to decide what we believe and how we want to think at any given moment. No one can take that away from us, thank God. That's always within our power, no matter how many circumstances change in the world. Now, another way to look at this is we can always choose between a gratitude lens or a fear-based lens. And a gratitude lens might look like savoring that first cup of coffee or tea in the morning, the sounds of your house coming to life with precious little ones or teenagers stomping down the stairs, a pet snuggling with you, right? Or watching the seasons change before our eyes. I'm looking outside right now, just this magical gold color, right? Or we have the choice to go with a fear-based lens. Whew. You know those mornings when you first wake up with a kind of deer caught in the headlights look and you're already overwhelmed by just the new day. You know, negative thoughts flying through our heads, all sorts of thought tornadoes. So the choice is ours. We can decide which lens to view the world on, this gratitude lens or the fear-based lens. I think this is a good visual to remember as we all have this choice. I've always preferred the gratitude lens. I mean, the glass half full was a trait I received from my father. He really modeled this for me. But I think that the most important lesson that he modeled was this. Seeing life through a gratitude lens is actually a decision that we must make every single morning. And this also applies when you're thinking about your future, doesn't it? Because you really get to choose what you want to believe. You have that power. You have that ability. And it is interesting when we start to believe in the bigger things and the bigger dreams, often people in our world will say, are you sure you want to try that? Or I don't know, I don't really see that working. Or something like that seems awfully risky. How are you going to pay for that? Now, you may hear all of these things or a variation thereof. And of course, some of these opinions are very well-meaning. But you know what? I shudder at how many dreams have been knocked down or ignored because of someone else's opinion or worry about you. So right here and now, I want to give you permission to believe whatever you want about your life and dreams. For example, some of you out there may have little children, and you believe that one day they're going to go to college, and you believe that they're going to get married and have children. Now, funnily enough, we don't really know if that's true or not, but you choose to believe that because that's your right to choose to believe that, isn't it? You have the right to believe their life will ultimately be rich and full, despite the given ups and downs. But here's the point. I think I'd prefer to hang out with those kinds of thoughts. Wouldn't you? Look, if I have a choice on what I'm going to believe, I am going to believe the best thing that I can think of. I'm going to decide what to believe, what to think, and I'm going to live and lean into that. And if I'm wrong, I'm wrong. I truly believe that the energy around choosing our thoughts is wise. It's healthy. It's full of hope. And I really don't want you to ever forget how powerful this mind-body connection really is. Our thoughts really do matter. They affect everything in our lives, our everyday reality, and even, well, especially our health. So choose your thoughts wisely. I hope this helps with that all-encompassing first question. Okay, so let's see. Hi, Leanne. I've had a group of friends for years that I feel are suddenly judging me. It's not a great feeling. How do I handle this? This is a great question because we all go through things like this. And I'm really glad you were vulnerable enough to bring this up. There is, unfortunately, nothing that any of us can do about being judged. People will judge us. And in fact, we all judge. We are unfortunately predisposed to this tendency. It's part of human nature. However, the good news is we can certainly learn to get better at not judging. But this made me kind of think it through. Why do we judge? And Carl Jung had a great quote on this. And he said, well, thinking is difficult. That's why most people judge. Kind of sums it up, doesn't it? Judging is really easy. Doesn't require much thinking or reasoning. Our brains are wired to judge others quickly so that we can move through the world without spending too much time or energy understanding everything we see. And understanding and having compassion for others is much harder, right? It requires a deeper level of thinking, awareness, patience, compassion, and an open mind. You know, I love what Jesus told his followers. He said, do not judge, lest ye be judged. You know, that always still stops me in my tracks. It helps me in those moments when I've been hurt and I realize, well, wait a sec. I could have made someone else feel the same way that I'm feeling right now. And I didn't even know it. Humbling when you look at it that way. It's interesting too, when I coach people who have low self-esteem, what I find is often they really aren't even aware of it. But how I can always tell is that they're terrified about someone judging them or having an opinion of them. And often they will just avoid a lot of friendships and scenarios and kind of hide in their worlds. But there was this one time I will never forget. I was coaching a woman who kept talking about, was very sweet. She kept talking about how much she loved her husband, what a great guy he was. And she kept saying how terribly unworthy she was in comparison. And I actually had heard her tell this story several times. And I finally had to say, hey, I just have to ask you, why are you so worried about what everyone thinks of you? And she said, well, I just want everyone to like me. And I said, well, I get that. That's human. But then I said to her, what if somebody told you that they didn't like your husband? And she replied, well, I would just tell them that they're an idiot. I said, really? That's so, so interesting. And she went on to say, well, they don't know what they're talking about if they don't like my husband. He is amazing. I said, yes, I love that. Now stay with me here. Let me just take you just one step deeper. Okay, so you love your husband and you believe he is amazing. So other people's opinions don't matter to you about him. That's what I'm hearing you say, which I think is awesome, by the way. But then I went on to say, but now, when you can feel that way about yourself, then other people's opinions about you won't matter either. And that right there, my friends, is freedom. Then you just get to be who you are, right? You get to decide how you want to show up. I always say, well, wouldn't it be amazing if we all just didn't care about what everyone thought about us? I mean, I certainly care about what my family thinks of me, and I especially care about what God thinks of me, but the rest of it, I'm learning to let that all go. How about you? So in wrapping this up, I was thinking there's two questions you should ask yourself. Number one, what is your opinion of you? And number two, are you willing to have your own back when someone else is wrong about you? Don't let somebody else be the authority on you. It isn't wise to give someone else that power. I hope this helps, and thank you for that question. All righty. So, this one is one on holidays. It came in this week. It's very timely. It says, hi, Leanne, I'm already dreading the holidays. This year coming up. No. My family tends to spin out of control when they are together these days. Any thoughts and suggestions? And I'm supposed to be hosting Thanksgiving this year, and frankly, I'm dreading it. Well, thank you for writing this in. I'm glad you're asking this type of question, as we all have so many opportunities coming up in November and December to manage our minds, don't we? So in thinking this through for you, you just might want to approach family gatherings this year with just a little more mindfulness. And I know that word is sort of thrown around a lot, but what do I mean by mindfulness? I just want you to think of these upcoming holidays as a chance to work on loving yourself and others more fully. And what does that look like? In order to love ourselves more, we all need to stretch, right? Just imagine that, stretch the limits of our love and choose to see everyone around us as divinely created, just like you. And remember, they're all struggling too, and are very valuable students and teachers in this classroom that we call life. My suggestion would be to choose someone specifically who you're struggling with loving right now, and focus on seeing them more compassionately, right? Instead of being irritated and resentful for the past interactions you may have had with them, why don't you look for the fear that is preventing them from being loving? What do you think? Are they scared? Insecure? Hurting? Perhaps you could choose to see them as just doing the best with what they know. I mean, look, we're all on this journey in this lifetime, and often we just can't see what we can't see, right? We might just not be there yet. However, all that being said, if you are dealing with a much more difficult situation, a difficult scenario, I suggest, limit your interactions with that person to protect yourself. And that's perfectly okay too. You could practice loving them from afar, even across the room if need be. Sometimes we need to choose healthy boundaries during the holidays to take care of ourselves But we can do this from a place of wisdom and love, right? And even if you don't want to spend all your time with them, I want you to consider that they are in your classroom for a reason. We all could choose to see the people in our lives as perfect teachers, right? Whose behavior is always serving us, especially when they get under our skin. You know, they're often the ones who push your buttons and offend you so that you have a chance to practice standing firm in your values, right? So when your brother-in-law starts in on a political rant, you can make that wise decision to gently change the topic. Or, you know, if all your people come in on Thanksgiving and they're all hanging out on their phones and you feel yourself like getting aggravated, you can suggest that everyone put their phones in a basket in the kitchen so that they can be present. I'm sure your own unique holiday situations are coming to mind right here. But in those moments, choose love toward yourself and others. It's such a powerful choice, even when it's hard. But it's a choice, right? It's the choice to be the bigger person. And one last thing I was thinking about, you know, bad behavior is often a hidden request for love. People who constantly cause family drama or conflict are rarely the ones with like solid self-esteem. They often lack wisdom and inner strength. But I want you to remember this. This is important. None of those behaviors is about you. So please don't take it personally. When we can choose to see others' unloving behavior as a reflection of a lack of love for themselves, our hearts can soften and fling open, right? Empathy can enter in. So during these upcoming holidays, I hope you can pause, right? Before you react to something or someone, and just choose a reaction that feels right with your soul. I think being aware that the world needs a little extra grace and empathy these days, that is a beautiful thought to adopt. But thank you for sending in this very timely question. I think a lot of people will really appreciate it. And the last question I chose, the reader said, "Hi, Leanne, my question is about relationships. I feel like my husband and I get into angry circular arguments that seem to go nowhere. And usually it's on the same topics. Do you have any suggestions?" Well, we all love you for this question because we all experience disagreements and blow-ups in our relations. And, you know, I think it's honestly because we don't know how to express ourselves accurately and honestly all the time. But when we're trying to resolve conflict, we have to dig into what I think of as the core of the issue. And this process always begins with self-examination. So step one, we need to just name our feeling. Often when we're angry, there's usually another more like raw emotion behind it, right? So there's the anger and then there's the other emotion. Are we scared? Are we fearful or maybe hurt? You know, our true feelings really can be unknown even to us over the craziness or busyness of our lives. So again, just name the feeling that's coming up. And even if it is anger, again, look for the more raw emotion that is behind the anger. And then step two is just to communicate, right? It's not until we can sit down and dig through and examine how we feel that we can accurately communicate to those we love. It's funny, we have to learn how to speak our truth in love and simultaneously learn how to not sugarcoat it. For example, it could be, I'm really angry with you, but I realize it's because I feel unsafe. You will get to the heart of the emotion behind the emotion. And in this case, behind the anger was the emotion of feeling unsafe, right? As human beings, we often try to hide what we feel, or we express it in super confusing ways. But I really want you to have the courage to tell others how you feel. Be honest, be truthful, and certainly don't let anyone bully you or minimize your feelings. Communicating exactly what you're feeling will hopefully allow for a deeper connection. And even if somebody doesn't agree with you, you open the door, right, for them to understand and possibly see it from a different angle. And that alone is powerful. And then finally, the third step would be to listen. Here's where the golden rule comes into play. Remember, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. You know, it's funny, we all desire to be heard when we share our inner thoughts, but we need to remember that this sentiment goes both ways. The other people in our life want to feel heard too. And in the heat of the moment, so many things might have been miscommunicated. We've all been there, but we all need to remember that, right? Truly listening allows you to win the heart of people you love, not necessarily the argument. And we have to ask ourselves, which is more important? So I hope these tips help. Once again, name the feeling, communicate openly, and thirdly, listen, right? Listen, remembering the golden rule. One of my favorite pastors, Andy Stanley, talks about this notion of becoming unoffendable. I think this really applies especially to step three. If we can listen and strip away our egos for a minute and really let whatever the other person is saying seep in without it offending us, that is gold. Right? We all desire connection. I believe that is everyone's deepest need. Let's decide to become unoffendable this holiday season. Don't you think that would be an amazing goal? You've been listening to Champion Your Life with me, Leanne Champion. Please connect, reach out, schedule. Take the time to schedule a discovery call with me. I'd love nothing more than working with you. You can find me at leannechampioncoaching.com, Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, or simply type in Champion Your Life. I look forward to the next time we're together. Godspeed. Thank you for listening to Champion Your Life with me, Leanne Champion, on transformationtalkradio.com. To find out more about me and my coaching platform, visit championyourlife.com. That's championyourlife.com. You have one precious life. Let's live it to your fullest potential. Let's go. Let's do this together. See you next time.